kids. So today we are going to enter into the new block, our block 5. So what are we going to do here? So here our aim is to identify the rhyming words and read the poem something new. So identifying the rhyming words, previously we discussed where the rhyming words will be there, how the rhyming words will be there. So basing on that, let us read the poem something new. So we are going to learn a new poem, something new. We want to read the poem and we are going to find the rhyming words which pronounce the same, like pot, got, not. So if you observe, ot, the same words repeating. So such words we call them as the rhyming words. So what words are repeating like that? Let us observe from the poem and read the poem. Okay, are you ready, kids? So let us open our textbooks and enter into our poem. Okay? So children, today we are going to identify the rhyming words from the given poem, something new. Okay, open your page number 32 and let us go through the poem. First see the 8 lines of the given poem. There is fun to be had in doing a new thing. Be a little silly, give your day some zing. Ever smiled with your eyes and laughed with your nose? You could try it out and see how it goes. So children, this is a poem which was written to fun. Means for making us fun, some funny actions we do and we are trying to do something new here. So that's why the title of our poem is something new. That means we are trying to do something new. Whatever we try to do something new, for that we can use this title. So there is fun to be had in doing a new thing. So something, whatever you do new, really we feel excited to do such things. Okay, so be a little silly. If we add some silliness to that, really it will be an excitement moment. Okay, so give your day some zing. Here zing means give your a new life for your day, means some happiness which will include in your day. For that, we give something for our day. So something new we are trying to do, which is really very silly. Okay, see the second paragraph. Ever smile with your eyes? Normally we smile with our mouth, but here they are saying to smile with your eyes, means our smiling, means whatever we do, the smile that must be shown in our eyes. And laughed with your nose. Can we laugh with our nose, children? No, but here he is asking us to laugh with our nose, which cannot be possible. Really, can we do that? No. You could try it out and see how it goes. So he is asking us to try it. Let us try and let us find how it goes, really. So is it not funny trying to laugh with our nose and trying to smile with our eyes? Yes, it cannot be done, but still, if we try to do, it makes us fun. So we may laugh with our mouth only, just because we are trying to do such silly things. Yes, so here in this paragraph, if you observe the last words, so normally previously we discussed that the rhyming words were according to the sound they produce and also basing on the ending words which are same for both the words, like pot, caught, rot, not. So all are ending with OT. In the same way, let us find the rhyming words in these two paragraphs among the 8 lines. There is fun to be had in doing a new thing. Be a little silly, give your day some zing. So children, here wherever you find the rhyming word, we can underline. So can you find in the first 4 lines? Yes, what are they? Check the ending words. Can you find them? Yes, now underline them. Okay, the thing and zing. Thing and zing. Now observe this next 4 lines. Ever smile with your eyes and laugh with your nose? You could try it out and see how it goes. So you might have observed the sound of the pronunciation of nose and goes. So both ending with O's. O-S-E, O-E-S. Both give the same sound like O's. N-O's, nose. Ga-O's, goes. So both are giving the same vowel sounds, same pronunciation. So that's why the rhyming words are nose and goes. So underline nose and goes. Okay, now let us move to the next one, the third paragraph. Try walking on your hands and writing with your toes. Draw rhinos flying high over a giant blue rose. Children, can you see here? Try walking on your hands. Normally we walk on our legs, but here they are asking us to walk on our hands. Is it really possible? No. Can you see the boy? How is he trying to walk on his hands? Yes, it is really funny to walk on our hands. Now see, writing with your toes. Can we write with our toes? It's really impossible to write with our toes. Yes, but we might have observed that some people, those who don't have their limbs, they don't have their hands, what do? They are trying to write with their toes. So it is really a tough task, but if we try, we can get it. Okay, but it's really silly to write with the toes when we have hands. Okay, now let us observe the next two lines in that paragraph. Draw rhinos flying high over a giant blue rose. So can you see there a rhinoceros? It is flying. Can it fly? No, it cannot fly, but is a new thing we are trying to do. We are making the rhinos to fly. Is it really not excitement? Yes. Making a rhinos to fly, it's of really very heavy. So a heavy, because if they are very light and they are having a technical support to fly, they can. But here, rhinoceros, we are adding some. Can you see in the picture? We are adding the wings for it by drawing. And over a giant blue rose. So roses are very small, but the poet wants a giant, very big. Giant means a very big blue colored rose. We want to draw it. On that rose, the rhinoceros is going to fly. It's really a funny thing to think also. So, but what are the rhyming words in these four lines? Try walking on your hands and writing with your toes. Draw rhinos flying high over a giant blue rose. So, toes, rose. O-E-S, O-S-E. Both giving the same sound, O's. Toes, rose. So, underline toes and rose. Now, see the next four lines. Have your breakfast at night. Eat dinner at noon. Wear mismatched socks. Comb your hair with a spoon. Oh, so are we going to eat our breakfast at night? So, really we eat only tiffins like idli, dosha, chapati, something in the early in the morning for breakfast. Okay, that we want to eat at night normally. Nowadays we are doing also. Yes, the patients like someone old people, because they must not eat the rice because of sugar or something, they were eating the breakfast. Means whatever, actually whatever we eat at night, we call it as dinner. But so here they are calling the breakfast to be eaten at night and eat dinner at noon. So the really they want us to laugh. The poet wants us to laugh. That's why he is doing all the things which are in reverse. Okay, now let us see the next two lines. Wear mismatched socks. Can you see the boy wearing the socks? One pink color, one yellow color. Can we do like that? Really, if we wear some mismatched things, really everyone will laugh at us. And we are combing. He is asking to comb with a spoon. Can we do that? Can we comb our hair with a spoon? Really, we can't do that. Okay? But what are the rhyming words in these four lines? Once observe. Oon, oon. That is noon, spoon. So underline the rhyming words noon and spoon. Doing new things. Now last four lines. Doing new things can be so much fun, but you have to be safe. That's rule number one. See, observe here. So doing new things means we enjoy doing the new things, but really can we do the new things? Is it safe to do the new things? It's not safe. Something if you are trying new, you want to be very careful. We want to see our safe means we want safely we must be there and we want to try them. If really we can do, we must try it. Otherwise, we must not try such things, because doing such new things may be danger for us. Okay? And that's rule number one. So that is the main rule we want to follow, that when we are doing new things, though they are fun, though they are creating fun for us, we want to check whether they are safe or danger. Then only we want to do. Now in the last four lines, you can observe the rhyming words like fun, one. Though spelling is different, they pronounce the same. Fun, one. Okay, children? Now let us read the total poem once again. There is fun to be had in doing a new thing. Be a little silly, give your day some zing. Ever smiled with your eyes and laughed with your nose. You could try it out and see how it goes. Try walking on your hands and writing with your toes. Draw rhinos flying high over a giant blue rose. Have your breakfast at night, eat dinner at noon. Wear mismatched socks, comb your hair with a spoon. Doing new things can be so much fun, but you have to be safe. That's rule number one. Okay, kids? Now see the glossary. Mismatched. What is the meaning of mismatched? Something that does not match. Ravi's mismatched socks made everyone laugh. So if we wear something which is not of matching, different things wearing at same time, so we can say that is mismatched. Giant, very big. I saw a giant tortoise at the beach. Giant means here very, very big. So basing on this, you want to complete your volume. Now children, open your volume page number 31 and see the first question. Underline the rhyming words in this poem. Can you see the words? So where do we find the rhyming words? Basing on that, check the words and sounds of the words given and underline them just by matching each and every rhyming word separately. Okay? Now see the second question. Write one rhyming word for each word. So it is given as bake, cake. So for dog, observe that last is ending with og. Find a word which is having an og sound at the ending. In the same way, complete each and every word. Honey, toast, bread, right, goat, and song. Now see the third one. Make two sentences each having a pair of rhyming words. So in the previous second question, we have bake cake. So on this they have made, I went to the lake and ate the cake. You can see lake and cake. So I baked a cake and ate the cake. I bake and ate a cake. So both using at a time. In the same way, the words which you used above can be taken and you can frame two sentences using the rhyming words you had written in the second question. So basing on that, you complete your volume and send the picture through the WhatsApp. Okay, kids, thank you.